In this video, we're continuing on with the KutaSoftware free worksheet, Proportional Parts in Triangles and Parallel Lines. You can find this within the Geometry section by following the link that I'll leave in the description below. Picking up where we left off with number 13, our directions are to find the missing length indicated. I'm going to introduce a new theorem that we're going to be using, and that's the Angle Bisector Theorem. Quickly, looking at number 13, ignoring the measurements, I'll go over the angle bisector theorem. So if we have a triangle, A, B, and C, and we have some point X where AX is the angle bisector, that means it will leave us with two congruent angles. So since AX is the bisector and X is on BC, then the theorem says that AB over AC, so this length of AB over this length of AC is going to be equal or proportional to the length BX over this length CX. So again, AB over AC is proportional to BX over CX. Now knowing that, let's get started with number 13. So we're missing this length. Let's call this A. So we're solving for A. So A over 30 is going to be proportional to this length, which is 36 minus 15, since 36 is the total length, and 15 is part of that total length. So 36 minus 15 is equal to 21. So A over 30 is proportional to 21 over 15. Now we'll cross multiply. A times 15 equals 30 times 21. So 15A equals 30 times 21, which is 630. And when I divide by 15, I'll get that A is equal to 42, since 630 divided by 15 is 42. So this missing length is 42. In number 14, we're going back to the other theorem, triangle proportionality theorem. So my missing length, I'll call this X. This other length that we do not know, we can calculate for. The total distance is 14, so 14 minus part of that distance of 8 is going to equal 6, that length. So we can say 6 over 8 is proportional to X over 12. Now we'll cross multiply. 6 times 12 equals 8 times X. 6 times 12 is 72, and that's equal to 8X. And when I divide by 8, 72 divided by 8 will give me a positive 9. So 9 is equal to X. So 9 is our missing length in number 14. First, I'm going to calculate this length, which is the only missing length. So that is our indicated length. And we can do this simply by subtracting. So 39, which is the total length of this side of the triangle, minus 24 will give us our indicated length. So 39 minus 24 equals 15. So 15 is our missing length in number 15. So in 15, we didn't need to use any of our theorems. In number 16, this total length is the indicated length that we're missing. So first, let's solve for this smaller portion. We'll call this X. So 28 over 20 is proportional to 7 over X. And that's because of the angle bisector theorem. So 28 times X will equal 20 times 7 when we cross multiply. So 28X equals 20 times 7, which is 140. And when we divide by 28, X will be equal to 5. So X is 5. But we're solving for this indicated length, which is 7 plus X. So 7 plus X equals our indicated length, and that's 7 plus 5, since X is equal to 5. And 7 plus 5 is 12. So our missing length in number 16 is 12. And now in number 17 and 18, we'll solve for X. Using the angle bisector theorem, first I'm going to calculate this length in order to set that up. That length is equal to 24 minus 10, which is 14. So 21 over 2x minus 5 is going to be proportional to 14 over 10. And a way to remember what side to put on top, the numerators, so 21 and 14, will connect to form an angle of the triangle that's not the congruent angles, and the denominators will connect to form the other angle of the triangle that's not the congruent angles. So the numerators will come together to form an angle that's not the congruent angles, and the denominators will come together to form the angles that's not the congruent angles. So cross multiplying, 21 times 10 equals 14 times 2x minus 5. 21 times 10 is 210, and that's equal to 14 times 2x minus 5. I know that 14 can go into 210 evenly, so I'll divide by 14 next as opposed to distributing. 210 divided by 14 equals 15, and that's going to be equal to 2x minus 5. Adding 5 to both sides will help me isolate my term with the x, so 2x will be by itself, and that will be equal to 20. So when I divide by 2, 20 divided by 2 is 10. So 10 equals x in number 17. And lastly, on this worksheet, number 18. Before I go over the answer to this, subscribe, like, and share. Setting up my proportion, 6 over 5 is going to be proportional to 12 over x minus 1. So 6 times x minus 1 equals 12 times 5. And that's what I get when I cross multiply. When I divide both sides by 6, 12 times 5 is 60 divided by 6 is 10. So I'll have x minus 1 equal to 10. And when I add 1 to both sides, I'll get x all by itself, and 10 plus 1 equals 11. So 11 is my final solution on the proportional parts in triangles and parallel lines worksheet. If you have any questions or just want to leave a note, put it in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe.